Fandom Arcade! Ready? Start!
Welcome to Fandom Arcade. I am Evan Atwood, and joining me is Daniel Sullivan. Daniel Sullivan, how are you doing?
I am doing fantastic, and as you know, we were gonna do this episode topless, but today was Butts Day.
So we are Butts.
We are Butts.
Yep. We are playing a Xenoverse 2.
Attention, all proud warriors.
Let's let Trunks explain the situation.
Joining Time Patrol?
I have Trunks.
Controller, you'll prevent history from being changed.
From the canon timeline, like GT. That didn't happen. Instead,
backwards.
It was two people being skewered. Instead of apes destroying the city, it was not apes.
Because time backwards makes apes.
Exactly. And of course, you know what? Let's just jump into this. Oh god.
Yeah, let's get this dumb universe rolling.
So Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 came out about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, you were one of the first in line, weren't you?
Yes. I was very, very excited for this game. And I have logged a few hours.
When I had the flu and was dying, you left me to go pick up your Xenoverse.
Of course I did.
I get that.
You are worthless compared to this game.
No, I totally get that.
And this game has exceptionally long load times. So this will
actually should give you a metric on how useless you are.
Exactly. So this will be a very different type of recording session because there are exceptional load times in this game, as we are going to witness many times. So this is my main character, Evan, who is me. I am level 69. There's the joke.
It's because of
things.
Yeah.
Because it looks like the Gemini Pisces symbol. I don't know. Which one's the one that looks like fishes?
Moving on.
Yes. So yeah, we're going to be creating a new character, and this is going to be a bit of a different recording session. Also I made a fat Piccolo.
Which,
using the boo.
I literally find that shit adorable.
It is so adorable. But we're going to be making a new character for this game. Dan and I talked about it behind the scenes, and we have an idea for a character.
Mm-hmm.
That we're going to be following on a brand new adventure.
Also, by the way, we're sitting so close to the TV that right and left stereo is a little bit of a thing, and my ear just pops, so all of a sudden I'm hearing things that I wasn't hearing before.
Yes. I totally get it. I can sympathize. I've been in similar situations. So because of the nature of this game, doing a normal format of like 10-minute episodes, it simply would not work.
It simply isn't done. No.
So we're actually doing freeform. We are going to break at length when we feel it is appropriate. And that might be 20, 40 hour and a half long episodes.
No. 20.
On YouTube, you'll know how long each episode is. Probably before or after, as soon as you click it.
But yeah. Or you can look at the length of time it is once you look at the YouTube link.
I don't know. That doesn't hold up to scrutiny for me, Dan. Wah, wah.
So if you don't like it, you're just not there?
No, I didn't put a ring on it.
Damn it.
So, I know. I nailed the joke.
So there is Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
I nailed the joke. Dragon Ball Z jokes. I love Dragon Ball Z so much. So this game features a robust character creation engine. You can play as male or female Majin characters, Saiyans, Earthlings. The Namekians have no gender, so it's just Namekian. And Frieza race, because they couldn't just come up with a word. They couldn't just come up with a single made-up sci-fi word. They just call them Frieza race.
And also that's like the equivalent of going the Justice League, Superman, Batman, Green Lantern,
Person Face,
stretchy arms.
Exactly. Yeah.
The one who can talk to fish but doesn't like it when you say that.
Exactly. God, I love Aquaman.
Impressive woman.
So,
No, wait, impressive girl.
Impressive girl. So we're
going
to be...
And Bobby Moynihan.
We're going to be playing as a human, which is so very rarely done in these games.
Yeah, no, look at that.
But yeah, let's go ahead. We were talking about it, and we kind of came up with an idea for a character, and we want him to be exceptionally average.
The Mike Nelson of...
We wanted to come up with normal human Greg.
So let's... can we tone down that hair?
Oh yeah. I mean, let's just do... Let's do style first, and then we'll change color. We gotta do something kind of... I mean, no matter what, it's going to be pretty anime, but we want something kind
of... Yeah, Yeah,
like Seven is good so far. Let's double check. I think Seven is the way to go.
No. Party.
Yeah, I'm still feeling Seven. All right, Seven is the way to go.
That is so fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's going to be like... I mean, purely based off the aesthetics of anime,
it's going to be bombastic.
Yeah, but we're going to try and keep it as toned down as possible. Like, that's pretty...
Yeah, no.
Pretty ordinary. Six is
good.
No,
yeah. Wait, go back one.
It can't be too heavy. It's be fairly...
Wait, yep. yep.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah, that was it.
That's 16. I just want to see what else is available. Yep. Oh, is that... Oh! Yeah, Krillin Dots! Which I actually just found out what that is. Do you know what those things are?
I do not.
There is a practice, which I believe was outlawed for quite some time, wherein monks would actually burn incense, like short, stubby incense, on their foreheads, and as it burned down, it would create those... it's essentially a burn mark.
Interesting.
Yeah. Very symmetrical burn marks. Okay, so noses. That's far too Krillin. I mean, that's about as generic. I mean, honestly, type 3 is about as generic as you can.
Yeah.
Mouth jaw.
Yeah. Maybe.
Let's start up at 1. There we go. There's no discernible
wow.
Very little discernible difference. Although I do like 1 better than 2. Nope. We're going to go type 1.
I like type 1 because it seems like it has a little bit of fat on it in the sense that it's like, you know.
You're like, yeah, he's kind of normal. Oh, type 3 is definitely the most average ears.
You've got type 3 ears.
So, and let's do hair color. Kind of want... like a dark brown.
I was gonna say the way I was calling it was unimpressive brown.
Yeah, it's too bright. Yeah, we need unimpressive brown. There we go.
Well, like, you know, my hair was unimpressive brown until it started turning gray.
I think your hair is a remarkable like mahogany meets salt and pepper.
Well, so what was kind of cool about that is that it wasn't mahogany when we were kids.
Yeah.
Like it started getting blonder and grayer all at once.
Interesting.
Also, like when I was a kid, my hair was blonder than yours.
I mean, that begs to be seen. I was Shirley Temple blonde.
I'm talking about your hair right now.
Oh, my hair right now. Oh, yeah. Well, my hair was blonder than my hair back then. Dan, I gotta say, I'm not feeling these eyes.
I love these.
I love them too, but they're too weird. They're not normal.
Wait.
Actually,
that's
pretty, like, that is neutral.
Yeah, this man is unimpressed with life and how he's been beaten down by it.
Uh-huh. Let's do... Ooh, it's got a little shine.
Yeah.
That's a little shine. And now we can actually change the eye color.
Okay.
He needs...
I wish we had gray.
Dan, we do? Hi, I have gray eyes. Yep, He's dead inside. He is generic.
Normal human Gary never once has...
Gary? Greg.
What's the difference?
Very little.
But I was going to say, normal human Greg has never once been on an online date.
Nope.
Of which his date says, you have incredibly piercing eyes.
You have incredibly...
Eyes.
I feel like if he goes on a date, it's very like, wow, it's nice to meet you. You have really great... It's nice to meet you.
And then it immediately follows with, so I actually have to do something later, so can we do this drink kind of quick?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Oh. Do you want to give him a tiny scar?
No.
Okay.
Brr!
I'm just running through some different jaws.
Brr!
Just in case.
Brr! Yeah.
Actually, seven. Seven over one. Yeah, seven.
Yeah, let's do seven.
Doing seven. All right. I think we're about good. We're not going to worry about the clothes and colors and stuff right now. We're going to get into that once we actually pick his outfit.
No,
this is far too bombastic for a normal human.
I was going to say, it's like, you know that I care about the clothes. He needs to tone that shit down.
Dude, this game is the most dress-up, and that is why I love it. So
there it is, just out there.
Oh, God, yeah. Dude, this is... Oh, man, this is like cosplay dream fantasy. It's incredible. All right. I think this is about good. Go back to that. Name and voice. Let's give him name.
Controller.
Do we want his full name to be Normal Human Greg? Oh, what is his name? We need a very live on our Twitch chat. Throw us out some suggestions for very average human male names. Just go ahead and throw those out.
Yeah, okay, so
let's do his voice.
Okay, let's do some voice.
Yeah, let's do voice while we do that. Throw out some suggestions. These are all awfully young. Ooh.
That's kind of good.
Yep.
So I'm actually...
Let's check some others. It's
yeah.
weird.
I like 10.
10 works. 10 totally
okay,
works.
So as far as name goes, I was looking at our selection and seeing that we got John Smith as a suggestion. Now, see, here's the thing is that I'm taking that. Also, by the way, hello.
Hello, everybody on our live Twitch chat.
So I'm thinking John Smith is far too bombastic.
It is. Like we.
I'm thinking Chet Smith or.
Chet. Ooh. I kind of want to do just one. I don't want to do a first and last name. If we're going to give him, like, a name. I mean, we talked a lot about doing Greg. Greg. Let's just see how this looks. Greg. The normal human. Or normal human Greg.
So you don't want to do a first and last name, but you want to do a name and a title.
A name and a title, as long as the title is about how average he is.
Greg the average.
Oh, no, see, that sounds like a title. Greg the normal human just is explaining. We'll just do Greg.
Yeah, let's just do Greg.
We're overthinking this to a disturbing degree.
I just realized the fact that Greg. We are. All right,
hello.
Greg it is.
Greg, voice 10. There we go. There we go. That's the thing is, like,
I'm Greg, voice 10.
John. Like, the name John is almost too generic.
It's so average that it begs for a hero.
Exactly. And we don't know. We don't know if Greg... is going to be a hero or not yet. This is a game of adventure.
What fighting style do you like? Greg would choose
balance.
Not in the face.
Not in the face? No. We're going to keep it fair and balanced. We're going to have a very balanced, normal human character. So normal.
So very normal.
So very normal. So there
he
are...
buys... He is so normal, he buys Sports Illustrated and leaves it on his coffee table and actually doesn't read it because he really doesn't know that much about sports.
Yeah, he's like, you know, man, I thought I'd try and get into it, but, like, I don't know if it's me. I don't know if it's me. That is his answer. So, are you ready for plot, Dan?
All right.
Are you ready for Dragon Ball Z convoluted nonsense? Because
yeah.
We've got Scrolls. We've got Frieza. You know what that means? Means Bardock is there. And Planet Vegeta is toast.
Also, you got your classic anime characters making a massive declaration about what they will do.
Yep. And screaming Frieza. A lot.
Which also, did any of you watch Dragon Ball Z when it was in its ultimate heyday? Because that's one of those things, like, I remember getting into it by way of Evan. But the one thing that the show did not do was...
make sense.
I was going to say advance the plot in any timely fashion.
Yeah. Well, you... I don't know if I've told you this. The reason for that... we didn't need any dubbing there.
I mean,
sure, we'll have lines for everything else, but let's just have him open his mouth and then subtitle it Frieza.
Because
it's space. It's space, so no one can hear you be in space. So Bardock, prior to this situation, had been invading a planet of a bunch of telepaths, and one of them, as a revenge tactic, gave Bardock the ability to see glimpses into the future.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of like, hey, dude, your shit's not gonna go great, and here you're gonna see it not go great. And so, kind of self-fulfilling prophecy, he kept trying to get the people, the Saiyans of the planet Vegeta, to rise up against Frieza. They all thought he was a crazy person, but it turned out that he was right, and Frieza destroyed the planet. Or did he? He did. And Bardock dies.
Or did he?
So, the story of Bardock... which was one of the first quote-unquote non-canon Dragon Ball Z movies that I purchased. Because they didn't air it on TV. I had to pick up a copy of that one. I fell in love with. It was the first Dragon Ball Z movie that incorporated a more modern soundtrack as part of its dubbing into English. And it worked really, really well. I got a super kick out of it. Who is that mysterious fellow?
I see we got Star-Lord here.
No, it's Bardock. It's the least disguised Bardock that a Bardock has ever been.
I don't know. It looks like Star-Lord.
In my playthrough, hasn't been revealed as Bardock. I'm 9,800,000% positive it's Bardock. Oh!
Meanwhile...
I forgot. So each race has a different opening scene to the plot of the game.
And our opening scene is in Dade County.
Yep.
The more average... Yep, our opening scene is in Dade County.
Oh, great Saiyan man. Who are you, truly, mysterious fellow? It's Gohan. Gohan is a great Saiyan man.
Hey, now it's your turn.
Yep. They practice posing.
Do I really have to do this with you?
The helmet people.
Yeah, pretty much. I would love to do a great Saiyan man.
Really?
Oh god, it would be a blend of anime cosplay, superhero cosplay, and ridiculous cosplay.
Oh, by the way,
it's the trifecta, really.
All of you out there on YouTube and Twitch, if you haven't seen Evan's Goku cosplay, it's actually one of my favorites.
Oh, thank you.
And I'm not the. I could. Yep, I'm just watching it.
Do it. Get some. Get pumped. Whoa.
Hug it.
Chug it.
Football. Great Saiyan woman is here.
Oh, she does a weird voice. That's weird.
Did she record this on Quaaludes?
So one of the things that you will notice about this game. Now, I will preface by saying, I freaking love. I love this game. I love it so much.
Taking a tally of how many times you say it.
Good luck. Some of the voice mixing, I'm not going to say the voice acting, but some of the voice mixing is unsettlingly atrocious. Just get wait until we start fighting Cybermen.
So
it's bad. Our scouter AI is talking to us.
The one good thing Greg did in his life to make him feel important was to buy Google Glass, and now everyone hates him.
Yep. And now we're going back to the Canton City, which was formerly Toki-Toki City in Xenoverse 1, which I will clarify, I have not played. I did not play. I had a lot of friends that were into it. I did play a little, but I didn't do like the full story. There were a lot of elements that were pretty broken about the game, and by the time I was kind of like interested in getting into it, Xenoverse 2 was announced. So I was like, I'll just wait and see if they fix it. And they actually did. They did a lot of incredible work on this game. Fixed a lot of the problems from the original. But that sound mixing. Oof.
So, Sky Dragon.
Yep. That's normal. That's a normal thing to happen. Orange Star High School, that's where Gohan went to school. In the game, it has name recognition.
Literally what you just did felt like a Seth MacFarlane joke of any time he says, "Ah, oh, you made a reference of something that I understand."
Mm-hmm. So the premise of this game, which I think is actually probably the most brilliant for doing a Dragon Ball Z game, is that time-traveling bad guys are messing with the timeline, and it's creating all kinds of weird what-if scenarios. And it's your job to go back in time and fight the what-if scenarios. So the plot of the game is the designers gave themselves an excuse to do whatever the heck they wanted.
Ah, that's a Kelvinverse move.
I know, isn't it great?
I love me some Kelvinverse.
And so this is the adorable Supreme Kai of Time. And that is Toki-Toki, the bird of time.
You've been chosen for that big mission.
That big mission? I know what you're talking about, but the audience certainly doesn't.
You ever feel like someone just tells you something because of expository reasons?
This is that.
To give you her best wishes, after all. I mean, don't you think you're being a bit cold?
No, that's one of the Frieza race. Bop, 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 jokes.
I'm not being a bit cold, I am a bit cold.
Yeah, it's chilly. It's chilly here. So we're looking for the old man. What old man?
Why don't you go and look for him?
Okay.
You know what?
Okay.
So some old guy is really proud of our success. Some kind of teacher figure. I hope it's nobody creepy and lecherous. Oh, wait, it's Dragon Ball Z. Of course it's
That's exactly what it is.
It has to be somebody creepy and lecherous. There's really no way
that
around
is,
it.
That is what and why.
Yep. It would be great if
What's
it was...
The...
It would be great if it was Master Roshi.
I like the big top music.
Get used to it, Dan. So one of the things that I actually... I just downloaded an update for is I think they did an add-on very shortly after the release of the game. That adds a DJ character, and I think that allows you to kind of choose what the hub world music is. Because this whole town is kind of like the hub world. It's also where you go to
right, I gotcha.
Grind for levels and take lessons and learn new attacks and things like that. We don't have a flying license. Yes, I know all of these things. Hooray. Yep. Mm-hmm. Totally got it. Yep.
Done and done.
All good. Yep, look how map that is. Dude. You know what you're gonna do? I'll find out. Oh,
dude, that shit is so map.
I go this way. So
wait a minute.
We can't fly yet, which is unfortunate because that is like the biggest handicap of this game, is not being able to fly right off. It's preposterous. But we do get cool hoverboards,
which is
fun for Tokyo drifting.
Hey there. Couldn't afford the other half of my shirt.
Yeah, it's on layaway.
I was born
looking
on the...
for Elder Kai. Elder Kai, that's the creepy old guy that we need to go talk to. Hooray!
I was born on the wrong side of the tracks, which is why I only have half a shirt.
Yeah, look how hero I am. Well, that's kind of... I mean, this is... Just like the first universe, this is kind of like DeviantArt the game. Original character, do not steal. Mm-hmm. And also, if you hold the brake, which is X, and then hold the zoom button, and then release the brake, boom! You get a little speed boost right off the bat.
Hello.
It's a minor thing, but I think it's fun. A little bit of polish. Elder Kai, yeah, he was busy about things. Okay, better go. Whee! Also, we gotta collect all of these things all the time.
That's one of the things that, you know, as much of a gamer that I am, also being a massive story enthusiast, one of the things that I gotta say is that it always takes me out of the reality when people are just, name your game. They're either laying ammo, or they're laying coins, or they're laying whatever all over the most obscure places.
Mm-hmm.
Why is everyone short?
It's an anime-based game, dude. See, there you go. So Xenoverse did a weird thing where they decided to make, like, female Majin characters, even though they're kind of basically genderless anyway.
Right, right.
But all of the Majin ladies are just adorable.
Yeah.
That is just, they're adorable. All the Majin dudes are big fat guys, but all of the Majin ladies are adorable. That's where we're going now. Wow, we're going this way. Whee!
That's the power of love.
That's the power of love.
That's a Back to the Future reference involving a skateboard.
It's true. We're going to be doing plenty of ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba's because this is a game about time travel.
Yep, there we go.
So let me check because... What? Wrong button. When you are playing a separate character, you do still have some use of items from your other game. So I have a whole bunch of stuff available that I normally would not otherwise.
But we have a mission. We have a mission with our character to make him average as fuck.
He has to be super normal. They're closed right now. Let's see. I think, I'm not sure if I have the normal clothes that I want for Greg yet.
Everyone out there, remember, you know.
Normal. Very normal. You know what's not normal? Scouters.
We got any fashionistas out there? Remember, we need to make this the most normal of normal.
He's got
to
be normal. Those are like short pants. It's not very normal.
No.
Not gonna lie, it's pretty not normal.
That's not normal either.
Nope.
What we need is a pair of like
stats be damned.
We need
a
pair.
Pretty
normal.
Not normal. Not normal. Not normal. Nope. There we go.
What I was gonna
look at
say
that, slacks and a belt.
Yep, I was gonna say we need a pair of jeans that aren't fashion jeans, but you can tell we're clearly bought ill-fitting.
Yes. Okay, so
now I think the slacks so far are the best. Those True. Are too trendy and modern.
I know. I'm just double checking what we have so far. Okay, yeah, so
yep, there we go.
Commander Red Pants, those are just basic pants. It's about
some fucking pants.
What do we got for shirts?
You know, one of the things I really wish
it's too suit.
I so wish we could have reduced his muscles.
We made him as thin as possible.
I think
for the time being, jacket. At least we'll do Time Patroller jacket. For the time being, we'll go ahead and do Time Patrol. But there is a specific shirt that I think is perfect. And no gloves. People don't wear gloves. That's preposterous.
People don't gloves?
Let's do... We need very normal shoes. Those are pretty normal shoes.
That's pretty damn normal.
Yeah, those are pretty normal shoes. I see laces. Those are like baseball uniform shoes. Sneakers.
Yep.
There we go. He's got his sweet kicks, which we can change the color of.
All the other kids with the pumped up kicks?
Yep. So Dan.
Yes, sir.
The track jacket and the shoes we can change the color of.
What
is
the most normal
color?
Actually, we're kind of nailing it right now.
We are, but we could possibly nail it harder. That is the most useless color option. We can change the color of the zipper. A little metallic zipper there. What's normal? Aren't the sleeves of those types of track jackets usually the dark colors?
No, no, no. The sleeves are usually the white.
They are? Okay.
Yeah, because this is a combination between a track jacket and a letterman's jacket.
Got it. So we'll go... Yeah, we'll just go there. That's fine. I mean, this is pretty normal to begin with. Very normal. Most normal. Look how normal
Greg,
he is.
And also, his name hovers above...
Greg!
I'm Greg.
Hello, Chikori. My name is Greg. Hello. And of course, we can't move for shit because we don't have our flying license yet, so... C'est la vie. Hoverboards. That's pretty normal.
Wait a minute, hold on. Normal Greg. I just nailed the first line for normal Greg.
Yeah?
Go over to Mantu real quick.
What's up, Mantu?
Hey, I'm Greg. You want to go on a date at a Panda Express? Yeah, you know what? I'm busy anyway. I gotta go.
Let's
home.
See, I gotta go on this special mission.
Yeah. Yeah, but
a totally normal, a extra dimensional entity has a mission for me involving time travel.
And
normal,
and
very normal.
And probably making photocopies.
Exactly. Where are you? You're saying it was my fault. Stop blaming your failings on others, you young punk.
I can't help it.
It's... Now listen up. You've been chosen for a very special, very normal mission. This is a great honor. You'll only be the second elite member ever to do this.
Oh, the second, huh? So that's,
it's pretty normal.
Yeah, that's second. It's like, well, someone's been here before.
Your job is to travel to eras where changes in history have been made and fix any errors that may have occurred. However, you still have much to learn. First, you should learn from the wisdom of those that have gone before you. Wait, so if I'm the second, then there's one. There's one person who's gone before me. That's the first game. Once a change has been made to history, it becomes easier for subsequent changes to be made to it as well, thus making it easier for the game designers to come up with crazy random things to do.
Giving screenwriters an easy time of it.
Yeah, prologuing this game. Okay, off you go. Wait just a moment. Blah, blah, blah. No. No, I know how to fight. I don't need to. No, we're just skipping. There's honestly, okay, there are going to be points where I will just be skipping. Just chunks of stuff. Believe me, I've played it. I know when it's just useless.
So,
and there's so much loading in this game. You will see loading to a splash screen to then load some more. This is loading the game. And unlike previous, see? There's a splash screen. Okay, good that we loaded that.
Yeah.
And now we're loading again to this, which is in turn a cutscene loading into the gameplay. Huzzah.
My ice cream headache.
I have such a headache.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you know, I've never been able to get over his hair.
Which, Goku?
No, Raditz? No. Raditz.
Yeah.
No, that's one of those things where it's like, love DBZ, but I've never been able to get over his hair. That's one of those things, I always put it on the back burner, kind of like, hey, you know, we all pay our penance.
Well, the weirdest part is, Saiyans are born with their particular hairstyle, and it doesn't change from birth. So Gohan, his hair changes over time. But imagine a baby with Raditz hair.
Jesus.
That's more hair than baby.
Poor woman who gave birth.
Right?
Hey, guys. Is there a Subway around here?
I.
What's the sandwich of the day? $5 sandwich of the day.
Yeah, I mean, whatever's the most normal. Whatever's the most normal way to do this. I'm hungry. I normally traveled through time. Yep.
Listen, if you're busy, I can leave you alone. I just, I like to get my sandwiches with the chips and drink. I don't know.
So, I've already gotten to level 69 with my primary character. In between episodes, I'm gonna turn the volume off on the controller. That
I
is
totally
really annoying.
Forgot about that shit, dude.
That is really annoying. So the controller is telling me their lines, but it's offset enough because it's coming from two sources. I can't understand a word they're saying. I have not been able to. But, you know, it's just beat these guys up and things will be better. The game. What weapons do I have? Oh, I have that. That'll do something. Pump that up. Check out those pumped up
kicks. Listen, guys, I just want to finish up this fight so I can go to Home Depot and pretend like I know what I'm looking at. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Oh, fine. I'll hold him still. Oh, whoops. Missed my meteor crash.
If I hold him still past the fact, I get OT.
Yep. Double time if it's too long.
Time and a half if it's holidays.
I am out of stamina already. I haven't played as a human character yet, so there are some idiosyncrasies that I will
You
need
are
to.
Suffering the repercussions of being incredibly human normal Gray.
Yep. So human. So normal. So Finnish. Normal to just stop hovering sideways.
So Greg is so normal and human, his finishing line is, I wish the staff at Kinko's was more helpful!
Yeah. It's a very normal thing to say.
Yeah.
or he just finishes a fight and goes, I just won this fight! It's over now. Average and normal.
Anyone want to go to Karo's?
Yep. Very normal place to go.
What are you doing?
Just accept the love.
Giving you a bro hug. We literally, Goku just found out that he was an alien and had a brother. Canonically, like, an hour or two before this very moment. It's a little weird. You know what else is weird? They don't have holes in their chests right now.
That's a thing.
A little non-canon there. But it's a game for all ages. A lot of fun.
Serves you right.
Yep. Although I think at some point Elder Kai calls somebody like a dingus or like a butt or something. I don't know. It's weird.
A butt.
Yeah.
That's something you call someone, a butt.
It's true. I would call somebody a butt. Where's that guy who's helping us? Not gonna turn around.
Well, I got. Yeah, how you doing, bro?
Yep. The silent protagonist that we can fixate all of our own personalities upon. Yep.
Who was that man? That man who really was so unimpressive.
That very normal man.
He looked like he was from Wisconsin.
He looks like he was from somewhere in the Midwest. But you wouldn't be able to tell based off of the way he talked. You know what I'm talking about.
Those moves weren't half bad.
They were all bad.
Except for your end.
So,
it was goofy.
Yeah, my interest wasn't that great.
Surely yep. Have been defeated if you hadn't stepped in.
Yeah, if only time didn't change by getting Raditz winged in the shoulder by a single blast. Apparently that's all it takes to set off the timeline. But no, let's go muck about in it some more.
Yeah, I really screwed up the timeline. I don't know. It's, go to a Chick-fil-A or something.
Exactly. A normal place for chicken sandwiches. The greatest guy in the universe? I don't know, Elder Kai. Pretty sure literally everyone is probably better than you. Except at watching porn. Only then Master Roshi is better. No joke, in the manga and in the un-American censored versions, he basically spends all of Gohan's mystic training just reading porn.
I get that.
Yeah. He's like, no, go, run, do push-ups, I'll be over here reading my books.
Anyone who laid eyes on you would easily call you an old man.
It's true.
Don't even try to compare yourself to an adorable girl like me.
Who does the horse? The pantomime?
That is the most stereotypical. Oh! Potentially, like, menacing anime lady move ever. I don't know what that's called, but it's made very tropey in many animes.
Okay, then.
Blah blah blah.
You've gotta be bored half to death after listening to him.
Yes. Yes.
I am.
Yes. I am normally bored. I am normally bored full way to death.
I feel like Greg is so normal that he would accidentally let slip of the tongue and say, I got a gym membership. I've been like twice.
Yep. Yep. Pretty much. So, as I said, there are many, many different costume pieces to choose from in this game, including, so far to my count, 3 identical track jackets with different logos in the back. Otherwise, functionally identical. Each one of them has a corresponding pair of pants that bear no logos, so are 100% identical. So, too many options. There are too many options. But it is awesome.
Hmm.
So, blah, blah, blah. The last game happened, and a mysterious hero that was probably you if you played the first one, and that hero is... Loading.
Do you need a hero?
I need a hero through the end of the night.
Well, he's got to be fast.
And he's got to be strong, and he's got to be normal Greg. Mm-hmm. Locked it out.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, Sun Wukong, on our Twitch chat, says that time when, I think it was Master Roshi, shrunk himself down to watch Bulma undress, that is also, I believe, a censored version of the situation.
Oh
for
my
the American
god,
audience.
Are you serious?
I believe in Japan it was he shrunk down to sneak into the bathroom at Kame House and to watch her use the bathroom.
Oh.
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So, since I didn't play Xenoverse 1 on this machine, I had to pick a generic character to be the previous hero, and I chose this character, who reminded me actually of Bulma. I was like, she's cool. All the other ones were like weird and boring looking. She was the only one that was like, yeah, it'd be cool. She's got a cool design. Yes, vehicles. I know. They're
a lot of shirtless dudes standing around here. A
lot of them. So many shirtless dudes. Also, it's funny because you always kind of auto look at different things that are around you.
Yeah.
And you can jump up here. So I'm just looking up her skirt. Yep. Very normal. Very normal. And then considering it. Mm-hmm.
Also,
so let's see, where are we at now?
Greg is literally, anytime anyone compliments Greg's clothing, first mm-hmm. thing out of his mouth is, oh yeah, Sears was having this dope sale.
Yeah, yeah. Welcome. I mean, it was really, I mean, how could I say no to a good deal like that?
They call them mom jeans, and I call them functional.
Yep. Oh, also, I'll show you after we buy our very normal shirts. Our very normal shirt.
We gotta make Greg more normal.
Yep.
Oh, Greg is normal. The ill-fitting white-collar shirt.
Yep. The most normal.
Yeah, dude.
Is it okay to purchase this normal shirt? It is absolutely okay to purchase
I mean, it's
that
okay if
shirt.
It's okay with you.
I mean, whatevs.
You know, I'm up for whatever.
Let's see if there's any more normal shoes or pants. I think we've got, like, the normalest pants. I also find it weird that even though there's like costume items that you can't wear as certain species, it still lists as available to you, and you can get them as random drops as completing part of quests. I kind of don't like that. I think it's actually kind of not a great design choice. Yep, we got the most normal. We got the most normal outfit we can, and this is weird. This is weird to me. The robots have little robot scouters. Why do they need them? They're robots. That's like giving a robot a wristwatch. Why?
That's
Oh, look, a normal thing to collect right over here.
Yeah, normal. I just picked that up.
Yep, very normal.
Hey, if Greg was so normal, he'd return it to the lost and found.
He's pretty normal. we talk a lot about how normal he is. He's pretty normal. What's a normal color for this shirt? I think he needs like a white undershirt or like gray.
Yep.
A little off-white there.
And then can we get a brown for that shirt?
Sure. Let's check out some different.
Oh.
Oh, like a tan.
No, too much.
Yeah, too much color. He needs like.
Wait a minute. Let's go down here.
Yeah, do like the darkers.
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's one
like
of
a
the
dark
so
plum, purple.
That's the thing is that it's not a shirt. An ex-girlfriend went shopping with him, and he got that shirt because she said that that color brought out his eyes, and he said, "Yeah, yeah, whatever." Yeah. And then, of course, they broke up, and but he still wears the shirt sometimes.
Maybe like a light blue.
Too much.
Yeah.
Nothing.
I kind of.
Yeah,
like
this. Go with that.
The thing is, we can't change the color of his pants, but we can change the color of the
shirt.
Go
with that.
I like this. This is very normal.
It is normal.
So normal. So normal. Awesome. And do I have any normal accessories? Nope.
I'm looking at the shit.
Yeah. There's poop on a stick. Mm-hmm.
Ultra normal Greg.
Yep.
And his battle cry is, I have most of my bills set to auto pay.
What? He does.
Yeah, he's got.
It's true. It's a very normal thing. So for any of you out there watching, you may notice as you play this game that the items that you can purchase through the metal shop in-game, it's only open Friday through Sunday. However, yesterday, which was a Tuesday,
yes,
I just reset the clock and turned off internet access, loaded up the game, and was able to access the shop. So I don't know if that's going to get patched, but you can currently do that to trick the game because being open only on weekends is malarkey.
So you're saying you're fucked on time. You fucked with time.
Yes, in a game where I fuck with time, I fucked with time. Also,
hey, you pretty much nailed that one.
Look how normal normal Genie Greg is. Mr. Popo's
I can't.
Yeah, you can. You can very much.
No. Greg is normal as it is. Can we exactly. No more dress up. We got to go do Greg stuff.
No, this isn't dress up stuff. This is boost stamina recovery speed. Actually, yes, that would be really helpful. Yes. We will use the stamina recovery super soul. Benefits of playing this game after having crazy played it in another playthrough. All right. Look how normal he is.
Oh, man.
Look how normal. So normal.
I just want to park in a parking garage and leave before the 90 minutes expires so it's free.
Exactly. Because of how normal it is. So we're a normal human. You know what we should probably do? We should probably go talk to another normal human. A sort of normal human.
Okay.
A human who
Greg
would be...
So ultra normal human Greg talking to another normal human. Greg would immediately storm into the conversation and say, so you play McDonald's Monopoly?
Pretty much. Because I've got like some spare pieces, like if you want to like...
I got Park Place and yeah.
I'm pretty close.
Pretty close.
So this little bridge here is the bane of my existence. Because until you get your flying license and can just, you know, fuck all, fly everywhere, when you're going between areas... You can't jump over it. You don't have enough height from your hoverboard to get across that. It is the dumbest thing. It forces you to turn it off, jump out of that ditch, and then get back on your hoverboard.
Hi.
Let's take some instructing classes.
Took some classes at the JC just to.
Let's get some fight points. Getting them from instructors, getting experience from instructors is really kind of stupidly easy. You know, it's kind of set up to give you that experience and also boost the number of attacks you have available. So let's do that. Dodon Ray. That sounds pretty normal.
Once we're fighting, you'll understand.
Oh, I am not locked onto you, buddy. So sometimes I feel like the game auto locks you on to who you're fighting.
That would also not be the first game to do that.
No, but sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you have to lock on. Oh, I keep forgetting to teleport dodge. There we go. Oh, come on, buddy.
Now we got a comment on a Twitch chat that says, you can go over water in a normal hoverboard.
Exactly.
Also, those boards don't work on water unless you got power.
Unless you got power!
Ba ba da ba 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 ba.
Kick TN right in the back of his head. Which is what I just did. Normally. Untouchable. I am unbreakable. I am unstoppable.
You're a Bruce Willis.
I am unstoppable. I am a Sia. I am a Sia lyrics.
Or you're a Chris Pine in Denzel Washington, if anyone saw that movie.
Mm-hmm. I did not.
Really?
No. Describe it to me. Should I see it?
Yeah, no, absolutely. One of Tony Scott's last films before he unfortunately decided to exit this world.
Oh.
Ridley Scott's brother?
Yes.
Director of Top Gun?
I think we talked about this on a Mario Maker playthrough.
Oh, okay. Well,
What was the movie?
We might have been talking about Star Trek Beyond because Chris Pine is the dopest.
No, I mean, I think we were talking about... what's the title of the movie?
Unstoppable. Yeah. No, and I think we were talking about that because we were talking about Chris Pine, possibly.
Possibly.
Or Tony Scott.
No, we were talking about Tony Scott. It didn't auto-lock me on that time.
Yeah.
So it's funny, because sometimes you get in the habit of like, oh, I'm about to start this fight, let me hit the lock-on button, but the game already auto-locked you on, so
right,
you actually turn
right.
it off. It's happened to me a few times. And I don't know if there's like a rhyme or reason, like maybe it's only trainer battles that don't, I don't know. I haven't really paid attention because it hasn't bothered me that much. Because ultimately, this game isn't hard.
Yeah.
And this is something that I will say right off the bat. This game kind of tried to bill itself as it's a real action fighting game with all kinds of other elements.
That involve fighting.
No, it is not. It is an RPG game that has action combat system. That's it. This is about as a fighting game as Kingdom Hearts. I mean, okay, it is more a fighting game than Kingdom Hearts. Oh, I should probably use the things it wants me to use. Sometimes you have to finish off a trainer using the move that they are trying to teach you. Otherwise, it won't let you complete it. But it's unfortunate because sometimes you have to complete a level with a shitty move that they keep dodging.
Also, by the way, great average line. Here I go.
Well, also that move is volleyball fist, so it's actually using like volleyball positions.
Right, right.
Which is, I think, pretty normal. Boop-a-doop. Look how normal he is. Although his shoes match his shirt almost too much.
Yeah.
I think we should change that. Change his shoes.
He doesn't have the actual ability to do good matching like that.
Exactly. Like, I think his shoes need to be kind of like a nondescript gray. Like, yeah. Like a dark gray. They need to match his eyes. They need to match.
Which is the color of his blandness.
Mm-hmm. You picked it up so quickly, it threw me off. That's kind of a weird thing to get thrown off by.
You were so good.
Also,
that
you fought Cell. How does that throw you? All right, let's change his shoe color really quick. Because I love playing dress-up in this game. We're not going to do so much of that with Greg. He's pretty much going to have the same outfit. His shirt and his shoes match far too much.
Okay, well, you match that. Give me one second.
Yeah. Boop-doop. Yeah, like a dark gray. Let's see here. And bottom of the shoes. Let's match that. Yeah, oh, look how normal that is, you guys. Oh, so normal. So very normal. We got a message on our live Twitch chat. No, we cannot do one red shoe. They change color at the same time. That is not a possibility. Look at how normal that is. Oh, it is actually kind of weird seeing a very normal person in this game of crazy absurd characters. Awesome. But I think we will go ahead and Dan, you back?
Yeah.
Cool. Dan's back. Hey, Dan. How was your very normal adventure?
So
was it this normal? Was it gray shoes normal?
So, would you like me to describe my very normal adventure?
Please do.
So, I went...
in as normal words as possible.
I went to the kitchen because there were some dishes left undone, and I thought to myself, it's like, you know what? You should do those. You really gotta, like, you're...
at least rinse them, you know?
You're 30 years old. You need to be on top of this.
Exactly.
But I looked at them, and I decided, oh, God, no, it's not like we're gonna have company. Why not just do it tomorrow?
Very normal. That's a very... I keep bumping into things.
That was my normal adventure.
That was a good normal adventure. So, one of the things I really love design aesthetic-wise, and we'll see, like, the true scale of it when we can actually fly.
The cell shading?
No, I was going to say, the hub world utilizes, like, all of the primary environments that the series takes place in.
Mm.
So you've kind of got, like, this city-ish area right here. You can see off in the distance the, like, the Namek area.
Yeah, yeah.
There's like a Mushroom Gorge area. And then there's like a more rural, like a bamboo forest, kind of where like Goku
right.
grew up, kind of rural area.
Oh, and also,
so it's really interesting, I think.
One of the things that I love is that on our Twitch feed, we got a comment that says that color makes them look more comfortable. And that is that not the pinnacle of normal?
Yeah.
Especially to like, one of the things. There's a guy who I could never figure out how I'm related to, and he shows up to my family reunion.
Uh-huh.
He's one of the Greeks.
he's pretty Greek, so I'm pretty sure he's related to me.
Yeah,
also, we just learned the Elder Kai dance.
I don't know about
this. I'm considering it, but nah, it's pretty normal.
It's going to fuck up my Tinder profile.
Still pretty normal.
But so anyway.
I'm going to fight another normal person.
He's the guy, so the guy who's at my family reunion, he is essentially the embodiment of normal Greg.
Yeah.
But he always walks around with a soda, like a can of soda, in a, what is it, like one of those styrofoam cozies.
Oh, no.
And he always tries to defend it, like somehow it's kind of like an okay thing. He'll always say, he's like, yeah, you know, it's really comfortable and,
it's comfortable?
Yeah, and also he says, and it keeps my beverage cold. And it's like, listen, dude, you stop trying to defend it. If you're gonna wear it, you're gonna wear it. But stop trying to make it something that anyone will care about.
Stop trying to make fetch happen. So I realized we haven't, like, I actually have a whole bunch of, abilities from my previous game, that we have not turned on, that we could totally turn on, and this would be way easier.
Yeah, but would a normal guy do that?
Yes. He would choose very normal attacks. I think he's gonna be pretty strike-heavy. I don't want to give him too many energy blasts, because that's kind of weird. That's not very normal.
Strike-heavy. You know, I just like to lay on the thunder.
Like, punches and stuff. I mean, if I didn't do at least a little of that, this game is not possible. You have to have good numbers, and you have to use the good attacks. Otherwise, it doesn't work at all. Also, time limits are malarkey. But kicks to the face, that's pretty normal.
And he's got, like...
Yep.
He's got, like, versions of that kick, or he's got pictures of that kick on his mantle. So that anytime he has a date come over, he'll have to tell. It's like, yeah, you see that time I did that kick?
That was a pretty good kick.
That was a good kick. That was a dope kick.
Exactly. Exactly.
It's pretty clutch.
Dan, stop trying to make clutch happen. Stop trying to make things happen. There we go. Loading. More. Yep. Great. Oh, 6-star Dragon Ball. Awesome. So, I find it funny. The game kind of gives you a Dragon Ball right off the bat. On my other playthrough, where I'm level 69, it's okay. We can chuckle. We can chuckle when that happens. I've only gotten 3 so far. I have beat up Frieza and his more powerful brother Cooler, and fought and defeated Beerus, the god of destruction, but I still only got 3 Dragon Balls so far. As is the way.
Alright, you talk to Kremlin.
I gotta talk to the Kremlin. They've got Russia missions for me to...
They've got Russia shit to do.
Very normal Russia stuff to do.
Yeah, like...
It is a 1-star difficulty level. I'm not even going to use
totally
my...
normal Russia shit to do, like
totally normal.
Shoveling snow off the driveway.
Exactly. I'm not even going to worry about spending my my level up points on any of my attributes yet. Oh, we learned Rise to Action. Which is actually good for using, for recharging your stamina.
Yeah.
So through this game, you get better and better. And stamina is useful, is what allows you to do those quick dodges and teleports, which is really the only way you get out of a lot of combos that you get locked into. Later, Krillin.
Bye, Felicia.
But I have not yet played as a Namek, but I've heard that they're the most broken characters.
Oh yeah.
So the Nameks have, each character has a transformation sequence. Saiyans go Super Saiyan. Humans can use the Nimbus Cloud and the Power Pole. Frieza race, they transform like Frieza does, I believe. The Majin Buu's just turn into, or the Majin characters just turn into Majin Buu, Kid Buu, with like palette swap color.
Weeboo?
Yeah, but like not a version that looks like your character. You just turn into that one character model.
Gotcha.
It is the most malarkey bullshit. But the Nameks, they get huge, like King Piccolo did in Dragon Ball,
uh-huh.
and Lord Slug did in the Lord Slug movie. Dragon Ball Z, none of the Namekians during like the Namek saga with Frieza and all that, none of them turned giant and wrecked house, even though that is a technique of their people.
A
very normal technique to just become three stories tall.
Yeah.
None of them did that. But in this game, the Nameks can do that, and you are invulnerable.
Right.
But it wears down your stamina. But if you put all of your points into leveling up your stamina gauge,
okay,
and then use the Rise to Action, you can just turn giant, powerful, and invulnerable, beat somebody up, transform back, power up your stamina again, and just do that over and over again.
Oh, okay, the most rinse and repeat of processes.
Exactly.
Also, by the way, I've got an overwhelming support on our Twitch feed that Clutch needs to come back. So, pretty much, yep. Clutch is coming back.
Is Clutch coming back? Okay. Well, then I suppose Clutch will have to come back next time on Fandom Arcade.
Next time.
Next time on Fandom Arcade.
On Fandom Arcade.
Mm-hmm. Next time on a very special episode of Fandom Arcade.
Which we can promise you, on the next episode of Fandom Arcade, we're going to introduce it like a previously on soap opera.
Exactly, and it's going to be great. All right, bye everybody.